Okay, so good afternoon. As I've said, good afternoon, Sir Dennis and Sir Alex. Once again, thank you for joining. No, this actually our last week, and I congratulate both of you. No, for all of us here are actually always excited in every knowledge deepening we have, because sabi nga nila. Kasi andyan talaga sila, sir, eh. So we have to meet. It's our responsibility. But anyway, the last topic is a sort of an add-on, actually, in online teaching. Specifically, my topic, this is all about social, ethical, and data protection and privacy implications, especially in the online teaching. I am not sure if you have browsed already the material, but my material is basically divided into three major parts, particularly on the fourth industrial revolution, followed by the social and ethical issues, data protection and privacy, then digital citizenship. As we all know, in the online teaching, everything is put online, right? Parang lahat na yata nailagay na natin online, and and we are not yet sure if baka hindi secure or whatsoever, and so on and so forth. Kahit yung mga ATM number natin, for sure, for the past almost 2 years siguro, naipasa mo na yung account mo online dahil hindi pwedeng pumunta ng bank or whatsoever. And all of this, nakakatakot yung tinatawag na digital footprints. No? So ano yung digital footprints? Yun nga, sabi nila, and many of the privacy experts said, data remains, once information is placed online, it always be there. Whether deleted mo pa siya, hindi yan actually nadidelete, because there is a so-called footprints, the digital footprints, no? Dati, footprints on the sand lang. Ngayon, meron ng digital footprints, no? And si ICT kasi, or because of the technological innovations, ang dami nang nangyayari, both social and ethical issues. Kahit hindi pandemic, maraming tao na nag-aaral dito, no? Ako, for example, I really studied about ICT, social and ethical domains of ICT as part of the teaching and learning process. Kasi yung research ko, I found out na less emphasize ito ng mga teachers, kasi nga hindi masyadong familiar si teachers, kasi nga they are too focused of the technological skills and the process of acquiring the skill, kaya hindi na alam ano yung mga social and ethical consideration. Nung dumating si, I'm not sure, familiar ba tayo sa Data Privacy Act? Sige, that's good that we are familiar with the Data Privacy Act. Napaka-late siyang naging 2012 pa itong Data Privacy Act. Unfortunately, hindi ito na-implement. Nagiging active si government natin nung na-create yung National Privacy Commission or NPC. Okay, National Privacy Commission. Commission pa lang siya. It's a subset of a unit in the DICT, Department of Information and Communication Technology. Bago din siya, bago na department. So nagiging active siya lately. So even before COVID, nagiging active na siya. Many schools, many hospitals, private institutions are actually implementing the Data Privacy Act, no? Like for myself, I am actually a national trainer for data privacy. No, data privacy, especially in the conduct of research involving human participants. And that was before COVID. Fast forward, COVID time, mas lalong nakakatakot si data privacy, you know, especially in the online teaching and learning. Please browse my material, especially the one that I shared from the National Privacy Commission, ano yung mga data privacy protection for students, for parents, and for teachers. Pinakasimple dito, Sir Dennis, to protect your privacy, dapat may virtual background ka. Or pag walang virtual background, tulad ni Sir Alex, may naka-blur siya. No? So, kasama yan. It's a simple thing in joining a video session, but it could create impact in terms of protecting your data and privacy. Oh, ayan, nag-blur na si Sir Denny. No? In your respective schools ba, meron na ba kayong department of or a unit handling the data protection? Do you have a data privacy office or something or related office?
Wala po.
Wala. Yeah, kasi hindi pa naman mandatory ito, but time will come, magiging mandatory ito. Mandatory in the sense that the university, the school, no, the school should really establish an office called Data Privacy Office and should assign someone called Data Privacy Officer. Kailangan, kasi yun ang sinasabi ng data privacy. Ah, POD. POD, that's privacy. What does it mean, Sir Alex?
Yung ano po, prefect of discipline po namin. Sila din po yung nangongolekta, sir, nung mga pinipirmahan ng mga magulang sa handbook. Ayan, yung agreement po. Ayan. Kasi in our school po, there are some students po na hindi po talaga pwedeng makausap ng kanilang relative. Kasi for example, naghiwalay yung parents po. So that's their privacy. Parang to inform us, sinasabi nila during enrollment na bawal pong kausapin si ganito, yung mga information. Even yung pagpo-post namin, sir, sa Facebook. Kasi may page po yung namin, yung institution po namin. Eh, ngayon po yung mga students po namin na nagkakaroon ng award, yung mga with honors, nakakuha ng perfect attendance. We are posting them in our, to praise them and also para mas ma-encourage silang mag-aral. And then, nagsisend po kami sa mga parent po namin ng personal message na pwede po ba silang ma-post kasi po, yun nga po, kasi makakakuha sila ng information. Nga po, yun.
Yeah, that's a very good practice, Sir Alex. Number one, if yung subject natin is underage, no, under parental guidance, much more. Pinakasimple kasi name kasi is a private information. Posting it somewhere, kahit hindi online, hindi talaga pwede yan. Nasa Data Privacy Act yan. Nasa 18, 16 items kasi na kinoconsider. Meron kasing tinatawag na private information, sensitive information. So, may kategory kasi yung data, yung information na pwede nating i-share. Name alone is already private. So, posting it anywhere, kahit hindi pa yan online, talagang bawal. So, bawal talaga siya. Now, kailan siya magiging hindi bawal? If you will seek consent. If ganito lang kasi yung bottom line ng data privacy. As long as there is consent from the concerned personality, okay talaga yan. So, okay talaga yan. Hindi talaga, sir, hindi talaga yung magpo-post ka on Facebook na kahit yung motive mo is very positive to encourage them, hindi talaga, sir. That's not unless, ang ginagawa ko, yung mga estudyante ko, meron silang mga alias. You know? So, ano yung mga alias? Sila yung pinagawa ko. So at the first day of my class, parang part ng ano ko, just, you know, gamification lang in my class. So I asked them, okay, ako kasi may mga team din. Like every, for this sem, yung team ko is superheroes. Ganon. Next, para madali kung isipin ba, or next sem, yung team ko are flowers. Ganon. So sila yung mag-identify ng alias. So pag mag-congratulate ako online to be posted in on a public, okay, on a public, what is this? On a public platform, tsaka na. No, hindi ko talaga ilalagay yung complete name, mga ganun, alias lang. At alam nila yon. Except lang, may mga ganito ako. O, sino yung gustong ipopost talaga natin yung, sino yung mag-allow na ipopost yung mga pangalan? O, syempre, yung mga top performers, sabihin, ako sir. Pag nasa bottom, talagang wag. Ganon. But, you know, in my study kasi, tayo kasi mga Pinoy, we don't matter that. No? Yeah. It's not really matter to us, especially if it will boost our personality. No? Lalo na pag praise, congratulations, and blah, blah, blah. Talagang, ano siya, walang problema yan. Hindi naman tayo ganun ka strict. Lalo na yung mga exams, sir, hindi naman talaga. Pero let us be very careful, tulad ng situation na sinasabi ni Sir Alex, na posting it on the public, yung purpose mo is really, really good, but there are matters behind their name that may affect tracing them. Actually, yun ang pinaka main point bakit ng privacy. Ayaw natin malocate. Yun lang naman talaga yung privacy. Lalo na yung mga address. Even telephone number. Supposedly, telephone number is a private thing. But look, tinan mo sa Pilipinas. So ang bilis-bilis na, especially the teenager and the millennials, di ba? Wanted text mate, tapos ipopost talaga yung number. Kasi there is a direct correlation hindi ng permanency ng contact number natin. Hindi kasi permanent yung contact number natin, di ba? Lalo ng teenager, tatlo, apat na mga phones or telephone number, walang problema sa kanila. So, ganun lang. But in the... nag-ask po ng GCAS. Yes, sir. the totoo. Oo. Ay, may nakita pa... At may nakita din ako kahit si teacher, birthday ni teacher, nagpo-post si teacher na birthday ko ngayon, willing to accept your donation. Tapos GCash. Tapos nagsishare naman si student, sir, 2 pesos lang kasi 5 pesos lang yung baon ko. And that was, it sounds funny, no? That's only in the Philippines, but... kidding aside, let us really be very careful, especially in the online teaching, especially to us teachers. Sometimes students, just last night, I read while I was preparing my material for, I mean, our point of discussion today, I read a viral discussion of students, a group of students and their teacher. Nagiging viral kasi si estudyante nagmumura kay teacher. Sa sobrang bait kasi ni teacher, wala, tahimik lang si teacher eh. Pero minumura na siya. Tapos nagli-leak yung group chat. Nagli-leak yung group chat ng estudyante. Ayun, nagiging viral and so on and so forth. Ang take ko naman is academic integrity. This is part, no? Yung data privacy kasi is always will hila to social and ethical consideration. And it always will bring you to academic integrity, something you have to behave in a class and so on. But my point is, we should establish, I think ang pinaka-basic na gagawin natin as teacher, we should establish our policies and guidelines stipulating social, what are ethical, talagang 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 yan. No? Halimbawa, like for Siliman, no talaga namin yung screenshot, yung discussions. Kahit si teacher, kahit sa class niya, tapos nag-video session, hindi pwede naman as long as hihingi ng permission si teacher na, okay, I'll take a photo, I'll take a screenshot, and I will post this on FB. Anyone who would like, who don't want to be included in the screenshot, again, parang is OP siya. Para hindi ma-accuse si teacher on the privacy. Although may mga estudyante talaga, may mga instance kami, you just imagine a student playing online game. Students are playing online game. Hindi ko kasi maintindihan yan. Students are playing online game, tapos nag-streaming live while they are playing ML yata yan. While naglalaro sila ng ML, live sila. Live via Facebook. Hindi ko alam bakit ila live. Tapos, that was a major exam ng estudyante. At talagang gustong-gusto ni estudyante na maglalaro. But he has to take the exam also. So ang ginagawa, while switching browse siya to our LMS and the ML, talagang nakikita yung mga questions and so on and so forth. So things like those. So when we try to handle the case, di naman alam ni estudyante. Yung mga ganon. It's serious naman yung, talagang honest naman yung estudyante na bago pa lang siya on the online game, hindi niya alam na mapipick up pala yung other tab ng browser niya. So yung mga ganong bagay. No? So talagang isusulat siya as part of your guidelines. Remember, we have a teaching guide or a lesson plan. It has to be incorporated in your lesson plan. Yung guidelines talaga. Like, what is your policy about copyright? What is your policy about copying a material from the net? Mga things like those. So, kailangan talagang ilalagay siya to your classroom. Now, if you notice, like in our virtual classroom, talagang isinama namin what is the guidelines ng chat natin, what is the guideline ng LMS natin, ano yung mga data privacy ng university that you have to follow, things like that. Kasama talaga siya in your virtual classroom. Talagang you have to share it to put it into your virtual classroom. And hindi rin pwede, our observation din is, hindi din pwede na you will just simply upload it because students will not care to read it. No? So talagang you have to explain one by one, describe one by one to the students na ito yung hindi pwede, ito yung pwede. Pag gagawin nyo to, minus 10, pag ganito, and so on and so forth. No, kasi talagang we have to assist our students in understanding the way we protect their data and also with our information as a teacher, no? And ito yung observation ko, protecting data and privacy is really an added responsibility natin. Before COVID, I think you will not matter. I mean, you will not care, di ba? No, siguro you will not care about you will announce perhaps to the public or post online or whatsoever. Any information about your students or lalo na yung magbigay tayo ng mga examples, no? Magbigay tayo ng mga examples in our class citing a student in the previous semester tapos complete name pa or whatsoever. Careful din tayo dyan kasi that can be a possible violation in the Data Privacy Act 2012, no? So although ang pinaka-importante naman talaga in the data privacy is yun nga sinasabi ko is there should be consent. If there is permission from the subject, walang problema actually. Kaya yung ginagawa ng university namin meron kaming collective agreement, meaning collective terms of agreement. So before mag-i-enroll si estudyante, he or she cannot proceed if hindi siya mag-click ng terms of agreement namin na yung account nila pwede naming i-visit, na pag may mga for congratulatory and for the to help the university advertise at their blah 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 and so on and so forth. Talagang isusulat. No? So, doon lahat ilalagay mo in the terms of agreement so that the students would know. But yun nga lang, like in my material, no one actually reads terms of agreement. Ikaw, Sir Dennis, nagbabasa ka ba ng terms of agreement nung nag-create ka ng Facebook? May Facebook ka, Sir Dennis? Oo. Binabasa mo yung privacy settings ni Facebook?
Nag-click lang ako, sir. Kasi hindi ako i-accept, sir, pag hindi ko clinic siya, sir.
That's true. Oo. Kaya yun ang joke namin, sir. Ano siya? It's a forced agreement. Oo. Kasi if you will not click that one, ay hindi ka makapag-create ng Facebook. No, but research shows that only 1 is to 100. No, sorry. 3 is to 100 magbabasa ng terms of agreement. You just imagine that. So hindi talaga magbabasa. Kaya biglang lalo pa tayo, no, sa Pilipinas, we're fun of joining yung mga games na yan na ano ba yan, yung how do you look like 60 years from now? Oh, di ba? Tapos may mga apps. Oo. So actually yung mga ganun, sir, they are actually collecting information about you. No? So they are collecting information about you and then pwedeng ibenta nila yung information mo because that's part of their business. So ganun siya. Like ako, I really don't entertain those kinds of apps, no? Kaya si TikTok banned in the US and some other countries dahil meron silang data privacy violations. No? Pero tinan mo si teacher, tinan mo yung students, mga politicians natin, nandun sa TikTok kasi it's a good platform. But ang sinasabi ko naman is I'm not saying that we are not going to use this tool. What I am saying is let's just make this tool responsibly, because itong mga tool naman na ito ay talagang ginagawa for the good purpose. Depende lang kasi if we do not know how to manage well our privacy. Being a teacher also, we need to understand digital citizenship. I think our students are familiar into this because this is part, I guess, in their empowerment technologies in the senior high school. But my point is, for us teachers also, we should be able to know about digital citizenship, especially if we are teaching online. No, in teaching online, kasi ang daming mga opportunities that will give us opportunity to violate laws. Ang nakakatakot kasi meron talagang law, no, which is the Data Privacy Act. Before kasi okay lang yon, kasi it's more of ethical consideration. Hindi naman tayo will put into prison if we are unethical, kasi hindi naman siya legal. Kaya ngayon, ethical, tapos paired with legalities, nakakatakot na talaga. So that is why we have to be very, very careful. Education 4.0 tools such as yung mga AI, artificial intelligence, that really help sometimes improve our teaching and learning process, because it can augment actually. Unlike if face-to-face na or manual or the brick and mortar type of education, yung technology naman kasi nakakatulong talaga. Nakakatulong in the sense that it can make tedious tasks more easy. No? So let's say for example, that digital tools that we shared, you just imagine yung mga referencing, you just imagine yung mga searching, all of those stuff, napakadali if you are going to use that effectively. Kaya nga, kaakibat in the development of the emerging technology is actually the technological risk. And part of those technological risks actually in the data privacy attacks, especially now in the online, lahat, no? Online lahat. Even our sensitive information, yun nga sinasabi ko, kahit mga bank statement and so on and so forth. As a teacher, especially in this time of pandemic, we have to be socially and ethically appropriate among our learners. And meron ako mga checklist, those social and ethical considerations, paki-browse kasi talagang dapat malalaman natin yan. No, there are many things that we should know, and sometimes we do not know na we are violating na pala. Now, for example, a simple usage of a video from the internet, tapos sinama mo siya sa presentation mo, tapos hindi mo siya ina-acknowledge, pwede ka nang ng copyright. So things like those, even your image, everything, no? So that's part of the social and ethical considerations. And especially if you are a researcher also, especially those when you collect data, much more, no? From your students, if you collect data from your students, if you conduct survey among your students and your students are underage, napaka more that you have to be very extra careful. So ang gagawin natin, hindi ko sinasabi na hindi na tayo magsisurvey among our students. Ang gagawin natin, meron tayong term. Halimbawa, like in before you join here, meron kami doon na I agree the blah blah blah, di ba? So lagyan mo lang 'yan nandoon. Pag hindi na i-click ni student, especially pag under 18, under parental guidance pa sila, yan, we have to be very careful into that. Pag under 18 kasi normally talagang lagyan mo ng the parent, you or your parent or guardian can answer this, no? Dapat may mga ganun kang statement, or you will have a statement stating that I fully understand with this and I am not forced to respond into this. Something like that. So, like halimbawa, in all our survey in my office, if you notice, lahat ng, in fact, kahit yung mga survey evaluation namin, yung last paragraph, if napansin nyo, all information collected in this survey is blah, 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 and blah, blah, blah. So, ganun talaga. No, so you can copy that also in all your survey. Lahat ng survey namin merong ganun. Merong ganung statement that is for anonymity, in relation to access to data, because that is really part of the Data Privacy Act in the Philippines. Okay? So our activity actually for this last week, para ma-exercise natin, try to update your syllabus or your teaching guide, your lesson plan, and then pakilagay naman ng implementing guidelines or a guidelines. Hindi kailangan comprehensive. Ang sa amin lang is ma-exercise kayo paano ba siya gagawa ng guidelines, no? For your example, you can actually refer to our classroom guidelines. No, you can refer to our classroom guidelines, you can refer to our chat and video guidelines. Now you can actually modify that. No, you can refer that, just modify it, and then ganun. Para meron ka ng classroom policy. If there is an institutional policy already, the better. Okay? The better. Hindi mo na kailangang uulitin 'yan. Sasabihin mo na lang na the policy, the institutional policy on the sharing information online will be applied in this class. Meron siyang ganun. Tapos, for sure, meron ka pang specific guidelines for your class. Okay? So, hindi siya ganun, hindi ito napakahaba. Ang importante lang is aware si estudyante na meron palang standard, meron palang baseline in terms of the social, ethical, privacy, and safety guidelines. Simple, pinakasimple, may guidelines ka ba during video session? No, may guidelines ka ba yung pag-mute and unmute? Yung mga ganun. Do you require ba, sir, participant or your students to switch on their video, Sir Dennis? Ah, do you require, sir? Oh. Accordingly, sir. Oh, accordingly, we will not require. No, we will not require, especially if ganito. Meron namang mga caveat lahat. Hindi naman talaga pwedeng hindi sabihin natin na hindi pwede. May caveat yan. For example, if your university during enrollment, if your university require stated, if you have an institutional policy stated that in all video session, all students should switch on their video, walang problema yan. Kasi meron na kayong covered umbrella policies. So okay yan. No? So ang pinaka-importante is if there is an established policy already, it must be written and it must be circulated among the students. Diba? So ganun lang siya, napaka ano lang, and then as I've said, you can, for your example, you can actually copy, browse our guidelines, implementing guidelines. You can also look at our data privacy guideline and so on and so forth. Kahit draft man lang yan, ang importante is nakapag-exercise ka as a teacher to, or kahit ano lang, 1, 2, 3, 4, and inform your students about your policy. Okay? Sige. That's basically for this day. And I think this is my last live session before the culmination on Saturday. No, I think Sir Dennis and for Sir Alex, one of our committee will contact you because I think they will ask you to share a testimony during our live culmination on Saturday. They, I think, yes.
Sir, yun nga po ang ano ko. You know, as an Adventist po, that's
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Kaya okay. Lagi na po ako nagsasabing thank you po na sinasabi ko pong marami kaming natutunan, sir.
I forgot. Yes. Oh, that's very acceptable, sir. And they have questions, Sir Dennis? They have other things to share about our topic?
Kagaya po nung sinabi niya po, noon pong start ng class ko, parang isinare ko din po yung mga nakita ko pong ibang guidelines, sir. Inilagay, lalo na po sa paggamit namin ng cellphone, sir, kasi nagcha-chat po. Mayroon po akong mga ibang part doon na kinopya din, sir. Mabuti po pumapayag naman po kayo na kopyahin para din po sa guideline. Kasi there are times na yung students are not using the chat ng mas maayos po. Kaya nagawa ko po yung sinabi niyo, sir.
Nice. I'm happy for that, sir. Oo. Dapat kasi lahat ng teacher meron talagang guidelines. If walang institutional guidelines. Sa Siliman kasi meron kaming institutional guidelines. Eh. So ang ginagawa na lang, the teacher will just post it and then we keep on reminding. Sige. Sir, I'm so happy to have you once again this afternoon. And sana may natutunan. Sana may natutunang bago. Yan ang palagi kong sinasabi. Sana may natutunang bago. Yeah. Okay. So,
sobrang dami, sir.
but no problem. Oh. Anyway, siguro that 9 weeks, imagine, sir, 9 weeks talagang nakapag-survive. No?
Kasi so, sir, nakikita ko every week is a challenge po. Tapos yung mga activities, kahit ako'y nahuhuli, sir.
Oh, okay lang yan. Okay. Sige. So we are ending our session for this afternoon. Bye sila, Sir Alex, bye Sir Dennis, and thank you very much.
Thank you po.
Mm-hmm.